Hello, welcome back. I'm Noreen Burke, owner of Call Clutter Fairy Home Organizing, and this is my YouTube channel, The Crafty Organizer. I love bringing you as many tips as I can on how to get organized, declutter, do some crafts, DIYs, and upcycles. Today I'm going to bring you a glue review and tell you which glues work best for which materials. So let's go. So I started this because I use a lot of different types of glues and I thought it would be interesting and I had mentioned it and you guys definitely responded with yes, please do a glue review. So I decided to start doing some research and it's funny, I typed in different types of glues and Google says there are 5 types. There are hundreds of types of glues. But Google's right, there are 5 main categories that go by the chemical breakdown of what the glue type is. So I'm going to be going over the broadest categories, a couple of brands that differentiate from what they can do, and then go down a little bit more into the specific uses for these glues. So the first one we're going to cover is polyvinyl acetate glue, which is most commonly known as white glue. The benefits of this is that it's a water-based glue, so it cleans up really easily with some soap and water. The first that I tried is just basic Elmer's glue, and it's probably the one that you can find in every dollar store, Walmart, Target. It's easy to come by. It's super watery though, so whenever I've crafted with Elmer's glue, I hate it because it inevitably wrinkles my project, and unless you're using something really thick, I just personally don't like it. But it is great if you're crafting with kids or you're just starting out. The second glue I went into was tacky glue. Now, this is still very similar to the white glue, but it is definitely thicker. As you can see when I run a bead here, and first of all, it's hard to get out, you can see the difference in the tackiness when I touch the Aileen's glue to the Elmer's glue. Huge difference. And this particular glue, the tacky glue, does not bubble and buckle when you use it on a project, but it is still a water-based glue. Now, if you do use Aileen's, there are so many different formulas to use. So if you don't want a water-based, check out their website, but they have a different brand for every one of your needs. In this same family are fabric glues. Now, there are several different formulas, so make sure you're buying one that matches your needs. Some are a temporary, some are a permanent. The one that I have is also the Aileen's brand, and I was surprised that it's kind of a crystal versus a white, but this is great if you don't want to pull out the sewing machine and you don't want to stitch something by needle and thread. And as you can see, it comes out with the same consistency as the white glue. It just happens to be clear. The last one we're going to talk about is a liquid adhesive, and this happens to be by Craftology. It's also a white glue, but it's very thick, and this is more for when you're adhering embellishments onto clothing and things like that. So this is kind of the white glue family. It's a very generic, most of them are non-toxic. They're great for the everyday craft project. Now we're going to go into the next category, which is Mod Podge. Now a lot of you might say, wait a minute, isn't Mod Podge a white glue? Well, the short answer is it depends on the projects. Mod Podge or other decoupage mediums have more ingredients than ordinary white glue, so it contains sealers and different varnishes, so it makes it much better for protecting and giving longevity to your project. So in this example, I'm showing you how liquidy it is, and that's what allows it to be such a great sealant, but it dries so crystal clear. So as you can see, I'm just spreading it out on the paper, and within about 40 minutes, it had this wonderful sheen to it, and you can see where it was completely protected. Something I was shocked to find out is there are 23 different varieties of Mod Podge. Who knew? Just a few of the varieties that are available to you are outdoor, there's a dishwasher safe, there's some with sparkle, and even a chalk Mod Podge. So if you haven't checked this out, try it out. The next one is pretty common, and that's just glue sticks, and this comes in a couple of different varieties. You can usually pick these up again at any dollar store, Target, Walmart, Kmart, wherever you go shopping. Of course, they have them at Office Supplies. I have always liked getting the type with color in it so that you can see where the glue is. It does dry sheer afterwards. One of the issues I have is that they're a low bonding adhesive, so it doesn't tend to last very long. But glue sticks are great if you're doing a quick project, if you're doing a little craft project where you're not worried about it adhering for a long time. And let's face it, it doesn't get any more economical than glue sticks. Around this time of year when it's back to school, you can usually pick them up for about 10 to 20 cents per stick. Next in this general family of basic craft adhesions is glue dots. I love using glue dots. They come again in a variety of different manufacturers, different sizes, different thicknesses. They also have them in permanent and removable, which is kind of nice depending upon what you're using it for. But basically, glue dots are a pressure-sensitive adhesive dot, and they're handy because you don't have to wait for glue to dry. So there's no wait time, no messes. I have a couple here that come on a roll, which is really nice because you can just find the dot of the size that you want, adhere whatever item that you're about to glue right onto the dot, peel it off, and then you're ready to stick that wherever you want on the project. That is just about as easy as you can get. So you can purchase these either on a roll, or you can see I have them in a bag here. I kind of struggle with these because sometimes the dexterity of peeling the two pieces of plastic apart is a little problematic, but the great thing about these is there's no odor, they're non-toxic, they're usually acid-free, so you can use them on a lot more projects. The thing I use my glue dots for the most is when I'm card making, scrapbooking, but also when I'm just doing seasonal decor and I don't feel like bringing out my glue gun. This is just instant gratification because it adheres instantly. Piggybacking on the glue dots, I've talked about these before, but I love using foam adhesive. I happen to think that this double-sided gold is just one of the best tricks out there when you are doing any type of crafting project. The foam comes in a variety of different sizes and thicknesses, and it just basically adds dimension when you're working with different paper mediums, or when you're working with other surfaces. So this is truly just a great tool if you're laying or attaching paper-based materials. I would not stick this on the wall unless it's a command-based product because it does have a pretty good adhesion, and when you rip it off, it's likely to separate and just leave some foam on the wall. If this ever does happen and you're trying to get that little foam mound off, just use a little bit of Goo Gone and a scraper and it'll disappear immediately. The last glue in the polyvinyl acetate category is my spray adhesive. And if you've been a longtime watcher, you know this is one of my favorite glues. I like this for larger projects. When you're trying to put wrapping paper, scrapbook paper, any type of large piece of paper on a bigger surface, let's face it, using any other type of glue just makes it tricky. It gets bulking and you don't have that good, smooth, complete contact. Spray adhesive will become your best friend for this. So all you do is spray both sides of the surfaces separately, let it dry, and that only takes a few seconds, and as soon as they come into contact with one another, it is instantly glued. So this really is ideal for a wide range of projects. One of the pros is that this is super easy to use, and it really is fast, and it gives you a good solid contact for a larger project. However, one of the cons is it needs to be in a well-ventilated area, and there is always overspray. So make sure you're either doing this outside with something underneath where you're using it. Make sure you're placing your project in a box if you can, or on top of a tarp. The next family we're going into is aliphatic glues, which basically means wood glues, like the Elmer's wood glue, the Gorilla glue that's for wood, or Tight Bond. The reason you want a different type of glue when working with wood is its sanding properties and also the ability for you to be able to stain and paint on top of it. Oftentimes, woodworkers will use this with a little bit of sawdust because it also works as a great filling agent. If you do use wood glue, be aware that it usually requires clamps for a good solid strong bond, and it does take a long time to dry, usually up to 24 hours to cure completely. Here's an example. I did this little sample at 8:50. It is now noon and we still don't have it completely dry. So if you are using wood glue, make sure you have plenty of time to let it dry and set. The next family of glues is my favorite and what I use the most, and that's the cyanoacrylates. And yes, I had to look up the phonetical sounding out of that and I had to practice. So cyanoacrylates, or super glues, crazy glues, it bonds very quickly, which means it works fast, and if you're not prepared, you'll have something glued in the wrong spot, including your fingers, so please be careful. But it does work with a variety of different materials and surfaces. So one of the benefits of instant glue is that clamps are usually not needed, although if you have something that's thickly applied, you will need to hold it a little bit longer. With these types of glues, less is more. You definitely don't want to get crazy and really saturate an area because it will take a lot longer to dry. So one of the benefits of super glues is it does dry clear, it's waterproof, and it is very fast setting. One of the downsides of this is it's very toxic, so please be careful. Check the labels before you use it. And this is definitely something that's better used on completely flat surfaces. It's not recommended for anything that's porous like woods or fabrics because it won't bond together with the other side. Another difference that I like to use is there's a liquid and a gel. So if I have something that is just a little bit like a For example, when I'm gluing two pieces of glass together, if it has any type of break in the surface, like this candle holder that I attach to a little cup, this is when the crazy glue gel works really well because the gel will fill up the little nooks and crannies and allow me to get a nice tight bond easily. Now that is the perfect segue into my next favorite glue, which is an entirely different family, and that is polyurethane adhesives, but everyone else calls these the E6000s and the Gorilla Glues. These are the glues that I use in my crafting most often. Right now, the basic E6000 does have a strong odor and you will need to use it in a very ventilated area. However, one of the best benefits for this is it truly can be used on just about anything. Fabric, glass, plastic, ceramics. I think that the E6000 is magic. About the only thing I would say is I wish it did set faster. Oftentimes when I'm gluing a project, I want that immediate gratification, and I'm sure you've seen many other YouTubers who have done tutorials, and what they'll do is they'll piggyback E6000 with either a super glue or a glue gun so that it sets in place and doesn't move but gets that nice strong hold at the end. Now Gorilla Glue is actually really different from the E6000. Yes, Gorilla Glue can handle metal, stone, wood, ceramics, foam, glass. It is the beast of all glues, which is probably why it's called Gorilla Glue. But most household projects, this can absolutely handle. But there's also different types of the Gorilla Glues, so you need to know which type of project you have. The other thing you really want to know is most of these, unless you buy a specific formula that's clear and more liquidy, it will bubble and it will expand. There's oftentimes, if you're using it with wood, for example, it will recommend that you get the surface areas damp, not wet, just slightly damp. And when you put a thin bead of Gorilla Glue, what happens is the glue activates with the water and it will start to expand and really reach into every little nook and cranny of your project. And this gives it a really nice strong bond. The downside to that is, as you can see, it will expand into the other areas and often bleed out. So if you're using this on a fine china, a small delicate piece, be aware that this glue will spill out. Now, if it's a larger project like this little cake stand I made, it's not a big deal to take an X-Acto knife and cut it off. It's actually very interesting because it turns into almost a foam, and that's been fun at Halloween for a couple of out-of-the-box projects. Just be aware if you've got something very delicate and you want that clean visual look at the end, that it does have a little spill out. Epoxy adhesives are the next big family of glues, but I did not cover this in my video. I have not had a lot of experience with epoxy glues, and as I was researching this, I genuinely found a plethora of videos out there that were really detailed in the very expansive types of epoxy adhesives that are out there. So if you're interested in working with epoxy adhesives, definitely Google that or go onto YouTube and just put in epoxy adhesives, because there are so many options out there that I honestly couldn't wrap my head around it. But the last glue that I want to talk about is the granddaddy of all glues. It started out as a contractor's tool and adhesive, and it has absolutely been taken over by the crafting community, and that is the glue gun. So the glue guns, as I said, became popular on woodworking and construction jobs before they found their way into craft rooms. What happens is the metal tip heats up and it melts the glue, which makes it super easy to adhere anywhere. But obviously there's a burn risk, so please be careful whenever you are using a hot glue gun, and always make sure to watch little ones as they're using it. But once the glue heats up, it flows through the gun and turns that liquid adhesive into the perfect glue for ceramics, woodworking, and a huge array of craft things. Now, it is not recommended for non-porous or perfectly smooth surfaces like glass, mirror, smooth plastic. Here's an example of that cake plate again that I put together with Gorilla Glue. And you can see as I make this cute little design on there, I only wait about 2 minutes for all of that glue to dry, and look how easily it peels off. This has been fun during the holidays when I'm making snowflakes or I'm making spider webs, but it's not fun if I've glued two pieces of candlesticks together to make something bigger. And honestly, at any given time, it will release because it doesn't adhere into the smooth surfaces. So glue guns are amazing for just about everything except smooth surfaces. But even with that, there is a huge array of different glue sticks out there which would fit the needs for the specific materials. And if you want to get really fancy, there's even glitter glue sticks which you can use in your glue gun to really make things fun. So you guys, there are so many glues that I didn't even cover. There is contact cement. There's rubber cement, there's liquid nails, and actually liquid nails takes us into a giant rabbit hole of construction adhesions. To keep this video from being 5 hours long and broken into 6 segments, I found an amazing website while I was researching all of this where you can type in the material that you want to glue together. So it's thistothat.com, and this magical website will tell you the best glue to use for your project. Ah! I'm so excited about this website. So the next time you're working on something and you're not sure which is the best glue to use, just check out that website, and within seconds you'll have your answer of which adhesive to use. That's all I have for today. I can't believe we're in September. I just sent out my new friend mail yesterday and I'm really excited about that. I'm also starting to wrap up a couple of my virtual organizing projects, which means I get to start working with some new clients. Now, as I'm working with virtual clients, some are a great fit to share with you, but some of them are a little bit more difficult and very private, so I won't be sharing all of them. But please know, with the help of my patrons, I'm getting to help a lot of people out there who otherwise wouldn't get to have a professional organizer come in and help them get organized. So thank you so much to my Patreons. Here they are. And if you're interested in supporting something like this, that information is in the description below. Please make sure to comment on what your favorite glue adhesive was, and if I missed one, let me know that too. I will see you guys in just a few days. Bye.